showed up in space. We're leaving now. So get back on board right away.
A gate floating in space.
Are we supposed to go in there?
Sure does look really cool.
My, my, this is fantastic. They say Eden civilization is considerably advanced.
Seems kind of like overkill, don't it? Must have some great treasure inside.
So it's right on the other side. Eden, the Phantom Planet. The place where I was born. Mari Glenn.
We finally arrived.
Captain, are we ready to enter the gate?
No, not yet. Listen up! Eden is finally within our grasp. Who knows what's waiting for us behind that gate? Could be unending riches. Or it could be an unspeakable hell. Do whatever it takes to get good and ready for anything Eden might throw at us.
What is it, Kisala? How come you called me out here? Do you need something?
Jester, there's something I want to tell you.
Huh?
I'm nervous about getting any closer to Mari Glenn. Like I won't be able to be with everyone anymore. It's a scary feeling, and it's only getting worse.
Kisala.
I have a strong tie to Mari Glenn because of who I am. And I'm sensing that something horrible is about to happen. Something huge. And awful. Jester!
Then what are you waiting for? We gotta set out for Eden. Grab your gear and let's get moving!
So, this is a whole other galaxy.
Let's see. Presuming that the gate is a type of wormhole, there is a good chance that we are no longer in the Wilhurser system.
Look, over there!
Whoa! Now that's a gorgeous planet.
That must be...
looks like it's a highly civilized planet.
Finally, we've made it.
What treasures could it hold? Oh man, they must be out of this world.
Well, I guess we'll find out soon enough.
Look!
Is that some kind of tractor beam? It's like they're inviting us in or something.
As if they always knew that we'd be coming.
I don't know. I'm not buying it. Don't you think it's kinda unusual that such a civilized bunch had let us outsiders just waltz right on in like this?
Yeah, but what else can we do after coming all this way? We've gotta take our chances and land.
What's your take on it, Captain?
Just like Jaster said, ain't no use in running and hiding now. We might as well accept their hospitality.
Yes, sir. We'll follow their guide beam then.
What's that?
See? Told you we were being set up.
What the? Look at them all! I've never seen so many beasts! Oh, not even a Dorgonak is a match for a swarm like that!
Captain, what should we do?
Break out the big guns! Fire them at that huge fella there!
Aye, aye, sir. I'll start charging them up right away, then.
Big guns?
That's right. It's our number one weapon, attached to the bow. No enemy in the world can survive an attack from the big guns.
Enough time to charge up!
What do we do now?
Annoying little twerps.
This isn't good. The ship won't stand much more of this.
Look!
Him down, eh? Oh, it's nice to have someone on our side for once, isn't it?
Hey, don't they look like the robot we met in the labyrinth?
I think you're right. They must live on this planet. They're trying to protect us.
Well, if that's true, that must mean Eden didn't send the beasts in the first place.
Captain, the big guns are charged up and ready to fire.
About time! Have a taste of this, you bilge scum! All right, let him have it, Steve! Fire!
Firing big guns!
They're pulling back. Sure gave us a run for our money, though.
Oh, thank goodness.
There! That'll teach you to mess with us! You stinking piles of crap!
Hey! It looks like they're escorting us down to their city. I can't believe it. It's such a beautiful place.
Amazing. It's like the city goes on forever.
That's strange. For some reason, it feels so familiar here.
Of course it does. It's because you were born here.
But I was just a baby when I left this planet.
Oh yeah.
Still, I feel kind of nervous.
Hey, look at that. They're coming to greet us. She must be some kind of big shot around here.
Welcome to Mariglan. You have journeyed far. This place is known throughout the galaxy as Eden. I am Fradius, the queen of this planet. We have been waiting for your arrival for a long time. Welcome home, Irieth. Do you remember me?
Are you my mother? Finally. Oh, finally.
What's all this? So Kisala must be.
That's right. She's the daughter of the Queen of Mariglan. That makes her a princess.
Jester! You knew all about this?
Well, Kisala asked me not to tell anyone.
Why, you? I'm gonna murder you!
Welcome to Mariglan. You must be weary from your journey. Please, rest here for a spell to regain your strength.
By the way, Mrs. Queen, I heard Eden, Mariglan, holds the most prized treasure in the universe. I'm really fixin' to know exactly what kind of treasure they could be talking about. Think you could show me?
Most prized treasure, you say? Well, I'm not sure whether they qualify exactly, but we do have an abundance of precious stones and the like here on our planet. But I am not sure as to whether they are the treasures you seek.
Well, what do you know about this eternal soul thing? Cause I, as a pirate, you see, the thing is, I'd really like to get my hands on it, so, yeah.
How could you say that?
Come on. This is what we pirates do, Kisala.
Eternal soul. Yes, the eternal soul does indeed exist on this planet.
Oh-ho! Then it's true. Wonder if you couldn't, let us have it?
Papa! Will you cut it out?
Papa? I see. So you must be the one who raised Irieth. I don't know how I can ever thank you for what you've done. Very well, then. You shall have all the treasures you can find on Mariglan.
Really? Do you mean it? And the Eternal Soul, too?
That, unfortunately, we do not have. For that, you'll have to see Mother.
Mother?
Okay, sounds good. So all we have to do is go ask this Mother person, then?
I'm afraid that is not possible. Mother never deigns to listen to us. Seems I'll need to tell you everything. The sad tale of Mariglan. I shall reveal to you how we ended up where we are today. Once upon a time, Mariglan was the most technologically advanced planet in the entire Wilhurser system. But one day, the evil energy known as Rune appeared on our planet and began to eat away at Mariglan. Rune is composed of forbidden energy that gives life to the lifeless. As I'm sure you have already witnessed firsthand, those who fall victim to the Rune gain new life as monsters. Rune does not discriminate. No one can withstand its influence. Even worse, the Rune monsters on this planet are several times stronger than those you've encountered in the Wilhurser system. This is because Mariglan is home to a fearsome force that is the source of all Rune. Mother.
I see. So, Mother is the cause of all the beasts that exist throughout the galaxy.
Exactly. Once our planet was in Mother's grip, there was nothing we could do except to wait for the inevitable. The Rune that Mother released would eventually strip this planet bare. And once our world was destroyed, it would move on to another planet and repeat the same process. Rune is like a voracious microbe that feasts on planets. We quickly realized that unless we somehow stopped her, Mother would eventually destroy the entire galaxy. That is why I decided to seal Mariglan into a space-time cleft, into a galaxy in a different dimension. That was the only choice we had. Everything we did was for the protection of our beautiful galaxy.
So, you sacrificed yourself to save the galaxy. Now, very sad indeed.
I wish there was another way we could stop Mother. But unfortunately, we had no choice. You must understand, I love this planet very much. I could not hand it over to Mother without a fight. Desperately, I tried to figure out a way to save it somehow. There is only one person who could stand up against Mother and win. And that is the Star King they spoke of in Legends. Our greatest prophets predicted that the one who carried the Star King's soul would appear in 10,000 years. Believing their words, I sent Ragnar to each planet in Wilhurser, placing keys on each one that could open the gate to our world. It was a gate that only the one with the Star King's powers could open. It was the Gate of Hope. Irieth, you were still just a baby back then. I was sure you could live in peace during the reign of the Star King. So I left you to Ragnar. I did not want to see you grow up in a world controlled by Mother. I wanted you to carry the blood of the Mariglan people into the future.
Mom.
After we made all the preparations, we waited many long years for you to open the gates of time and arrive on our planet.
So that's how it happened.
Now that the gate has been unsealed, Mother is sure to use it to bring her malice to other planets, just as soon as she destroys Mariglan. Please, help us defeat Mother and bring peace to this planet, as well as the entire galaxy.
I get it now, Mrs. Queen. Just leave it to us, all right?
Yeah. Well, I don't know if I'm as strong as all that, but I'm prepared to give it a shot.
We'll fight for you, Mom. I promise. For this planet and our entire galaxy, we're gonna defeat Mother.
Thank you, Irieth. And thank you all so much. I believe in you. I believe in your powers. Please help us Mari Glendons learn to smile again. A man named Yuvan waits for you near the South Gate. Go speak with him. He will lead you on your way. Go forth, brave warriors.
Wait, let me get this straight. Pirates fighting to save someone? Since when are we so charitable?
Yeah, well, what about it? Look, this planet is drowning in riches. What a terrible waste it would be if it all got eaten up by Roon. We'll get our share of them as a reward, I'm sure. Trust me, Zegrim.
If you say so.
Besides, have you taken a good look at Kisala's ma? She's a looker. How can you say no to a woman like that, huh?
I figured as much.
Thank you. Thank you.
can't believe the source of the rune was in Eden.
I can't believe they waited for 10,000 years.
At last we meet. I've waited so long for you to arrive. This is truly an honor.
For me?
Yes. Only he who has the Star King's blood in his veins can defeat Mother and bring peace to the galaxy. I have the utmost faith in your power. And Princess Irieth, within these woods, a trial waits for you. This trial is something you must overcome yourself.
A trial?
Yes. You will not be able to reach Mother's lair without first going through this forest. Be strong, Princess. You must steel your heart. I believe in you. I have confidence that you will make it through these woods successfully. May you both find good fortune on your way.
Are the woods really that bad?
Yes, it will be difficult, especially for Princess Irieth.
What does that mean?
It's all right, Jester. Don't worry. I have no intention of giving up. I'm not going to fail. I'm going to save this planet. The planet where I was born.
Kisala. All right, let's go. Thank you, Yuven. Goodbye.
Good luck, and be careful. Lord Albioth, Irieth has grown into a fine young woman. Soon, my duties will come to an end. Then I will be able to die without any regrets. I am certain Princess Irieth will make your dream a reality, Lord Albioth. She is destined for greatness.